1939, pioneer aircraft designer and builder, Jack C. Northrop, on the left, founded the corporation bearing his name. The first airplane built by the new company was the N-9M. It had a 38-foot wingspan and was powered by 265-horsepower engines. First flight was accomplished at Muroc Dry Lake by Vance Freeze on 3 July 1940. The next airplane built by Northrop was the N-3PB, a patrol bomber for Norway. This was the company's first production aircraft. These seaplanes were manufactured for the Free Norwegian Air Force during World War II. The first N-3PB was flown on 22 December 1940. North Stevens at Lake Elsinore, California. This is the XD-61 Black Widow Night Fighter, one of the first aircraft to employ a radar-controlled armament system. It could seek out and destroy enemy aircraft without the pilot ever making visual contact. For its day, this was a large fighter, but it had very good altitude capability and slow landing speed. First flight was on 26 May 1942 with Vance Freeze at the controls. This is the N-9M, a follow-on development of the N-1M. Wingspan was about 60 feet. The N-9M had larger engines, flared nacelles, and no droop to the wings as on the N-1M. Four of these aircraft were built as research vehicles, which led to the development of the larger flying wings. The first N-9M took to the air on 18 May 1943. John Myers was the pilot. This is the MX-543, a glider used for preliminary investigation of future flying wing designs. Initial flights were made in secret from a small dry lake near Baker, California. First flight was by Harry Cosby on 27 August 1943. This is the XT-56, an airplane created in response to the Air Force's request for a radical approach to fighter design. It first appeared with a very short vertical fin, but high-speed taxi tests proved this to be inadequate. A new vertical was added before the first flight. The XT-56 was originally designed for an inline engine, but due to lack of availability, an R-2800 was installed. On 6 September 1943, the XT-56 lifted off in Muroc Dry Lake. Upon touchdown, a nose wheel problem developed, causing shimmy and tire blowouts. The resulting crash totally destroyed the aircraft and seriously injured the pilot. John Myers suffered a broken back and multiple bruises, but recovered to fly again. A number 2 XT-56 was built. Both aircraft had wingtip venturas to obtain Q-force to power the flight control system and provide artificial stick force. For that era, this was a radical control system innovation. The number 2 XT-56 first flew on 23 March 1944 with Harry Cosby at the control. This is the air-launched MX-324, the first rocket-powered aircraft to fly in the United States. The MX-324 was towed aloft by a P-38. After release, the pilot ignited the rocket engine. It was designed to evaluate high-speed flight and rocket power propulsion. The first rocket-powered flight of the MX-324 was on 5 July 1944 with Harry Crosby at the controls. A flying bomb, the JB-10, was an unmanned pulse jet that evolved from the MX series aircraft. This is the XF-15, a high-altitude photo-reconnaissance aircraft that was developed from the T-61 Black Widow series. Its primary mission was high-altitude reconnaissance. It had a range of approximately 4,000 miles. The XF-15 was first flown on 3 July 1945 by L.A.'s Slim Perret. The XF-15A was a further modification of the XF-15. This particular airplane had turbo superchargers on the R2800 engines to increase its altitude and speed capability. First flight on October 17, 1945 was made by Max Salmon. This is the XP-79B, one of three prototype aircraft. The first two did not fly. They were originally intended to be powered by rockets. This airplane had two jet engines with the pilot lying prone in the middle. The aileron control system incorporated the Ventura system, which originally appeared on the XP-56. On 12 September 1945, this airplane, the XP-79B, crashed on its first flight, killing its pilot, Harry Crosby. First of the big flying wings, the XB-35, had four sets of counter-rotating propellers. Its four Pratt & Whitney Wasp major engines developed 3,000 horsepower each. Wingspan was 172 feet, and takeoff gross weight was 162,000 pounds. The XB-35 was designed to carry a normal crew of 9, with additional space for 6 relief crew members for long-range missions. This airplane was capable of flying 10,000 miles. Armament consisted of 20 .50-caliber machine guns with remote fire control systems. The first flight was made on 25 June 1946 by Max Salmon as pilot. Co-pilot was Fred Brecher, and flight engineer was O.H. Douglas. This is the N-23, a tri-motored airplane designed to fill a post-World War II need in commercial air freight and short-haul passenger operations. The first flight of the N-23 was made on 21 December 1946 by Max Salmon. The YB-49 was a jet-powered flying wing developed from the XB-35. 8 jet engines developed a total of 32,000 pounds of thrust. Takeoff gross weight was 213,000 pounds. The wingspan was 172 feet. The YB-49 set a record for jet aircraft endurance flights early in its program by flying 9.5 hours without refueling. First flight of the YB-49 on October 21, 1947 was from Hawthorne Field, which has a runway length of less than 5,000 feet. Max Stanley on the right was pilot. Fred Brecher in the center was the co-pilot. O.H. Douglas on the left was flight engineer. The XP-89 was an all-weather interceptor with a sophisticated radar fire control system. Later versions of this aircraft were extensively used by the United States Air Force's Air Defense Command. The XP-89 first flew on 16 August 1948 with Fred Brecher in the cockpit. This is the X-4. Two of these flying research vehicles were built for use by NASA and the Air Force. They were powered by two jet engines. Wingspan was approximately 26 feet, and takeoff gross weight was 7,000 pounds. It's rumored that early in the flight program, this airplane actually exceeded the speed of sound in a dive near Muroc Army Air Base. However, no data is available to substantiate this claim. Minor vibration problems were encountered, but were corrected later in the program. Flight testing was carried out on this airplane to evaluate tailless swept wing configuration. The X-4 was first flown on 15 December 1948 by Chuck Tucker. This is the YC-125, an outgrowth of the test program conducted on the N-23. Intended as an assault cargo aircraft, this particular airplane carried rescue markings. Designed for truck bed level loading from the tail, An interesting fact occurred during its preliminary design phase. It reached an excess of 6,000 pounds of the design weight. This fit is a record for several years until a company in Fort Worth managed to over-design the final gross weight of theirs. The first flight of the YC-125 was made on 1 August 1949 by Max Stanley. This is the YRB-49, which was actually one of the original XB-35s that had been modified to accept jet engines. Four jet engines were buried in the wing, and two were suspended on pods under the wing. This airplane carried a crew of five and was specifically designed for the tactical mission of photo reconnaissance. This airplane was first flown on 4 May 1950. The pilot was Fred Brecher. Co-pilot was Dale Johnson, and flight engineer was Frank Schroeder. The YF-89 was a further refined version of the XP-89. The nose was redesigned and fuselage modifications were incorporated. A later production version of this airplane carried and fired the first nuclear defense rocket, the MD-1 Genius. The first flight of the YF-89 was on 27 June 1950. The pilot was J.J. Quinn. The F-89A flew later in that same year. This is the production version of the F-89 all-weather interceptor, commonly known as the Scorpion. Modifications were made to the tail and fairings between the engines. J.J. Quinn flew the first flight on 25 September 1950. This is the YT-38, the first supersonic aircraft designed specifically for the Air Force training command. Design goals aimed at maintaining a small, lightweight airframe were accomplished through use of metals and processes new at the time. The T-38 is powered by two General Electric afterburner-equipped engines. This airplane established the world time-to-climb record early in its operational life. The YT-38 was first flown by Lee Nelson on 10 April 1959. This is the N-156, a lightweight supersonic fighter that was designed concurrently with the T-38. Major differences between the airplanes were the N-156 had leading-edge wing flaps and provisions under the wings for carrying ordnance. The first flight of the N-156 was made by Lee Nelson on 30 July 1959. This is the X-21A. Taking off from Hawthorne Airport. This was a laminar flow control research airplane designed for the Air Force to investigate laminar flow performance throughout long-range mission profiles. Northrop built an entirely new wing of unique design and mounted the engines on the aft portion of the fuselage. Jack Wells made the initial flight on 28 April 1963. The YF-5A, an outgrowth of the N-156, incorporated numerous changes. The F-5A had sod-field landing gear and wingtips modified to carry either rocket rails or tip tanks. Additional storage stations were added to the wings, and two 20-millimeter cannons were installed in the nose of the fuselage. The F-5 epitomizes the lightweight fighter concept that originated with the N-156. F-5s are now operational in many friendly countries under the military.